That's supposed to be one comma zero. The second one.
Yeah, this question I gave as a homework.
The second one, right?
Second one, yeah. So let me write the question again.
The one comma.
Yeah. Manav and Dave, MD. Okay. Let me write the question. The question is x comma y, 1 comma 0, 2xy minus 2y, x square plus y square minus 2x plus 1. So we have to show that this does not exist, okay? Because we can't prove the limit exists. For that we have to prove for all infinite path. And to prove does not exist, it's easier, right? Okay, so
first we try 0 0 and then
0 0. Oh, you see, look at the order pair which I gave you right now. The question was wrong. Dev has been trying for a whole day putting 0 0 and he failed. So the waste of time in lockdown. Okay, so now see the order pair is 1 comma 0. We have to check the continuity, we have to check the limit of this function at 1 comma 0. So obviously we'll go along, you know, we'll go along y equal to 0 and along x is equal to 0, or what? X is equal to 0?
1.
1. Yeah, x is equal to 1, because the path should contain the point. Are you getting that? The path should contain the point.
Yeah.
Otherwise we'll deviate from the point, and that doesn't matter. That doesn't make any sense here. Right? So
yeah,
along y equal to 0, just find out the limit. I think I hope you'll get this now. Dev looks awesome in clean sieve. You know, my first impression was, my first impression was by looking at you in the first demo, I thought that Dev is very, you know, elder than me, actually, what I observed.
Yeah, even my parents were telling me, like, you didn't look like a child anymore.
Okay. So, along y equal to 0 means x tends to 1, right? So, we can write the limit as x tends to 1. And y, we'll put y equal to 0. So 2x, 0, sorry, that would be 0. 2x, 0 minus 0 upon, yeah. So
you get 0.
X square. So what is the limit?
Upon.
What is the limit?
1 minus 2 plus 1.
So
no, but we'll get 0 upon 1 second. Yeah.
0 upon something, right? X tends
zero.
To 1.
Right. 0. 1 minus 2 minus plus 1. 1 minus 2 plus 1.
1 minus 2
plus 1. You get 0 over 2. So it becomes 0 over 2x minus 2.
So what is the limit? Limit is 0?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Now what about along?
But you have to show the location.
Yeah. You can show. You can show. No problem. Or if suppose 0 upon finite value, it will always be 0, right? So now along x is equal to 1, so what we'll do here, limit y tends to 0. How should I write the limit? Limit y tends to 0. We'll substitute x 1 in the expression. So like this, x as 1. X as 1. Okay. So this would be limit y tends to 0, 2y minus 2y upon y square. And this is again what? 0 over?
0.
Yeah, 0 over 0. So what is the value here? Limit y tends to 0, 0 upon y square. So the limit is 0, right? Is it clear?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay. So limit is 0. So both are equal. So have you proved anything yet? Have you proved anything yet here?
they failed the first.
Yes. The first test failed. So we'll choose a curve that passed through that path, or we'll choose a path or the equation of the path that will that go through the given point, that pass through the given point, right? The point, the ordered pair is 1, 0. So the equation of that curve should satisfy the ordered pair, as well as satisfy means it will obviously pass through the point, right? The path will obviously pass through the point. So what kind of equation you can observe here? What happened?
I think Manav's connection is bad. It's showing on my screen that Hana is.
We'll join. We'll left. We'll join again. So what would be the equation of the curve here? What equation you will consider? So we can.
Y is equal to x plus 1.
Y is equal to x plus 1. Are you sure?
Sorry, other way around. One second.
Check the points also.
Sorry, x is equal to y plus 1.
X is equal to y plus 1, yes. Or y is equal to x minus 1. Right?
Yeah.
So this is the curve. This is the equation. So we have to check the continuity along this curve.
Yeah.
So that this idea can evolve by looking at the equation. We don't have to put a lot of investigation to find the curve. So what we'll do here. So xy tends to 1, 0. So we can take 2y common from numerator. That will give you x minus 1. Upon, okay, what we'll do here, y square plus x minus 1 the whole square. Is it clear? Because if you take x square minus 2x plus 1, that is nothing but x minus 1 the whole square, right? If you look at the denominator except y square, that is nothing but x minus 1 the whole square. Right. So I have just rearranged the term.
Yeah.
Now the thing is how to figure out the curve or the path which passed through the given point, okay, and which makes the which passed through the given point. And that makes the degree of numerator and denominator equal. You understand that? That was the important point I mentioned in the rule. The degree should be equal, right? Degree of numerator and denominator should be equal.
Yeah.
So if I put y is equal to x minus 1 here, so limit y will be replaced. So limit x tends to 1, right? So limit we are putting x minus 1 as y. Okay.
So y should tend to 0.
We are putting x minus 1 as y. So y tends to 0 and 2yy upon y square plus y square. So limit y tends to 0, 2y square upon 2y square, which is 1. So we know that 0 is not equal to 1. So limit does not exist.
How did we come up with the equation for substitution?
Yes. You were offline on that time. So see. When we take, we'll take common here. From numerator, we can take 2y common, right? And we'll get x minus 1. And from denominator, we can rearrange the term. And we know that this x square minus 2x plus 1 is x minus 1 the whole square, right? So once we are done with that, the objective is to get the degree of numerator and denominator to be same, right? You have to make the denominator and degree of numerator and denominator should be same here. So we'll replace we get, x minus 1.
We get 2y. Yeah, we get 2y x minus 1 and then x, we get, then x minus 1 the whole squared plus y squared. Yeah.
And even by looking at the, Dev didn't apply this actually. He directly answered that. So might be he look at the ordered pair. The ordered pair, the point was 1 comma 0.
Yeah.
So he might have observed that point and he tried to come up with the equation that satisfy the given.
That's what
equation.
I did.
Yeah, I know. So y is equal to x minus 1 will make y and x, that equation. That will give you the equation if you put y is equal to x minus 1, because x tends to 1. So y tends to 0. So y is equal to 1 minus 1, 0. So based on that observation also, we can do this. Okay. But the
objective... Is that a fine way of doing it?
Sorry?
Is that okay if we do that?
Definitely.
Okay, right now the question is easier than that.
I'm just giving you the method to figure out that easily, but by looking at the ordered pair also you can create the equation. And we just want one path which does not lead to the same height. Are you getting that? We just want one path. Okay, so now let's move to the next question. So limit x comma y comma z tends to 0 comma 0 comma 0 x z square 2 y square upon x square plus 2 y square plus z raised to 4. So this is the case where three independent variables are involved, right? X, z and y, x, y, z. So we are checking that continuity for three independent variable or 4D surface, okay, or 4D object, you can see. Okay, so now we'll apply the same thing. We'll go along x is equal to 0, okay, we'll apply the same thing. So along x is equal to 0, what will it give you? Along x is equal to 0, so limit x tends to 0, 0 upon x square, right?
Yeah.
Because for along x is equal to 0, you'll put x is equal to 0 throughout, right?
Yeah.
No, y equal to 0 and z is equal to 0.
What? Yeah. Yeah.
Right. Along x is equal to 0 means you will substitute y equal to 0, this y equal to 0 and z is equal to 0. And then it will give you the equation 0 upon x square and the value of this limit is 0. Right. Now, in case of three independent variable, we'll use the parametric equation to solve this type of question. Okay, we'll use the parametric equation. The objective will remain same. The objective of the question is to try to convert the degree of numerator and denominator equal, okay, by putting with some other parameter. Okay, so we haven't done the parametric equation so far. We'll do after completion of this chapter. Okay, it is like before 11th chapter. That parametric equation is before 11th chapter from your book, the book which you have given me. Okay. Yeah. So we'll do that later. What about the parametric? But you must know something about parametric. Like we always mention parametric equation in terms of
T.
Very good. So parametric equation is always represented in terms of T. So we'll try to choose the equation of the curve like along C. So what C should I choose here is we'll take, see, look at the this higher degree. We'll look at the higher degree. Are you getting that? What is the higher degree? Z raised to 4. Right. So we look at the higher degree. So let's say Z is equal to T, and accordingly we'll put the parametric equation for X and Y, right? In terms of T. So if Z is equal to T, Y should be how much?
Z squared. I mean T squared.
Right. The objective is to get all the degree in as in same, right? So Y is equal to T square, and what would be X?
Again, Y is equal to X is equal to T square.
X is equal to T square. Are you getting this, Manav?
No.
Okay. So see, what is our objective here? The objective is to bring the degree of numerator and denominator in the same degree, right? So if we'll look at the higher degree here, the higher degree term is Z, which has the degree 4. Okay, so Z raised to 4. So my
objective. So X square and Y square are both in second degree. So when we put T square, then we come T raised to 4, just like Z raised to 4.
So if X, Y, Z tends to 0, 0, 0, that order triplet, where T tends to?
Zero.
So now we'll change the limit, okay? We'll change the variable, in fact. So T tends to 0. What is X? X is T square. So T square into T square plus 2T square, the whole square, upon T square, the square, plus 2T square plus T raised to 4. Okay? Like this. We simply substitute those values here. So limit T tends to 0, T raised to 4 plus 2. Now you let me know the value here. I'm not going to calculate this.
3T to the power 4 by 4T to the power.
Yes, so the answer is 3 by 4. Okay. Did you get this, Manav?
Yeah.
So what do we observe here? That 0 is not equal to 3 by 4. It means limit does not exist.
Limit
at 0, 0, 0. Right? See, the issue is when we put 0, 0 inside the function, you might have skipping that, because I am skipping that. If you put 0, 0, 0 in the given function, the function is undefined, or it is in indeterminate form. So then we are doing everything. Are you getting that? I'm skipping that part.
Yeah.
I don't know why, because I think we are used to that. we know that we are getting indeterminate form always, right? It would be 0 by 0. But that need to be checked. Why it is need to be checked? Why it is need to be checked? Any answer? Why it is need to be checked?
Because that point has to exist or something, right? Like on.
Could you frame the question again?
Yeah, the question is, see, we have been skipping putting the order pair or order triplet in the function
0, 0, 0.
To check whether it is indeterminate form or not, right? But that has to be done. So why you know we should check that is the question,
to see if maybe the ordered triplet, to see if the ordered triplet exists on the in the equation, like multivariable function or something.
So if suppose order pair exists, we are checking the limit, right? We are checking the continuity of the function. If point does not lie on the surface, obviously you won't get the value, and this is the case what we have been doing, right? Means the function is not continuous at this point, right? But if suppose we are skipping that thing, in case we are able to find the limit directly in the given domain, in case, see, recall your the concept of limit from IB. See, if we are able to put the values, we directly put the values to figure out the limit, right?
Yeah.
We don't go L'Hopital, we don't go to apply L'Hopital or any other trigonometry substitution or anything else. If we are able to put the values and find the limit, right? If the limit gives you the finite value, we simply put the values, right? So what does that mean? That means the function is continuous at that point because the limit is exist directly in the given domain. Okay, that is the guarantee that the function has certain value, the finite value at that point. It means the function is continuous at that point. Are you getting that? Because it exists.
So sir, if you if you substitute and you get a finite answer, that's a sure shot proof that the limit exists, right?
And the surface is continuous at the point.
And that, okay.
So, dotted pair given, right?
Yeah. So that is the concept we have been doing, I think, from IB also. In IB also we substitute the value directly if we are able to put the value and we get the finite value, right? But if suppose we get indeterminate form, then there is a question whether the surface is continuous or not. Am I right?
Right.
Okay. So we'll come to that part after this. Like we have been doing surfaces the limit does not exist, the limit does not exist, surface is discontinuous or not continuous. But where the surface is continuous, right? We are talking about all impossible scenario. We are not talking about the object. Are you getting that?
Yeah.
So we'll talk about that also
after
some time. So write down the next question. Now you find out some limit here. Today we'll mostly solving the problems, right? If we get some time at the end of the session, we'll might do some theory if we get time.
So this limit exists now because you can directly substitute.
Right. So we should not skip that. That is why I explained. You know, if you put the value into the function, if it is giving you the finite value, it means all the path leads to the same point or a same height on the surface.
So the limit is 3.
Okay. So the limit is
3. Limit is 3.
Yeah. So if suppose this is the surface, okay, or what kind of surface I made? Did you get the value here? I'm very bad in drawing, I observe. Okay, whatever. So this is a surface, okay? Some, you know, Alif Laila kind of the mat. You know that. There's a folktale stories, okay? We have been watching that. in childhood. So that mat, nowadays, you know, Harry Potter, the broom directly. Okay. So the technology has been advanced now. Okay. So suppose this is the surface, okay, and this is a point on the surface, and we have this point. We have to check the continuity at this point. So if suppose this is giving the finite value here, right, at the given point, if the function gives you the finite value, so all the remaining paths will lead to the all the remaining paths surrounding to that point will lead to that height only. Okay, that is means the that is the meaning of continuity in three dimensional. Okay, are you getting this? So basically, we are getting the finite value at the point. That's it. Okay. Yeah. Now let's move to the question here. Next question: limit x comma y tends to 0 plus 0 plus e raised to root x plus y upon x plus y minus 1. Why 0 plus plus? Any idea? Why 0 plus plus?
Right hand side.
Because we cannot substitute negative number, yeah, inside the root.
Yeah.
So that's why 0 plus plus.
So even this limit exists, no?
Yeah.
Minus 1.
What is the value? Minus 1. Okay. So these are the
minus 1, yeah.
So these are the values where the function the surface is continuous. The given surface is continuous. This is the surface. This is the surface. Okay, so these surfaces are continuous at the given points. Now, for three variable, we understood that we need to convert the equation in parametric form. Okay, so let's find out this. Have we done that? I think yeah, that we have done. No, this one. The next question, which is a different one. So limit x comma y comma z tends to 0 comma 0 comma 0, and the function is xy plus yz plus xz upon x square plus y square plus z square. Okay, now check the continuity of the surface at the point.
It's indeterminate form.
Yes, very good.
Yeah,
it's indeterminate form. And then what we'll do? Then we'll go along x-axis.
We'll use a pattern.
Yeah. First we can find out, you know, one path must be along x-axis, along the axis, right? Any axis you can choose.
So we get along x-axis, we'll get 0 upon x squared.
Along x-axis means we'll put y and z is 0, and that would become 0 upon x squared.
Yeah, 0 so we get 0.
Ultimately 0 upon x squared, and the limit is 0.
Yeah.
And then you'll have to convert this into parametric form to check the continuity.
So x is equal to y is equal to z is equal to t.
Yes. So that will convert the given function in the same degree. Both numerator and denominator will convert it into same degree. And what would be the limit?
The limit would be 1.
3t square upon t square. Yeah, 1.
Are you sure? Check it out again.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. 3t square upon 3t square.
3t square upon 3t square. Yeah.
My t square bad. Plus.
Yeah. I mentioned one in my note. That's wrong. Okay. So 0 is not equal to 1. So what does that mean?
does not exist.
Limit does not exist. At 0, 0, 0. Okay. Now one more sum, and then one or two more sum, then we'll discuss the continuity.
Yeah.
Write down exercise x question number this x y z tends to 0, 3, 1 e raised to sine pi x plus ln cos pi y minus c
in this case also we can directly do it, right?
So are you getting the finite value?
Yeah.
What's that?
Cos 2 pi is 1.
So we get and then 1 is 0. So we get 1 plus 0 which is 1.
The answer is 1.
Yes. Yeah, one.
So
plus one.
What did we observe? Never skip plugging the value inside the function. Right? Next question, x cube plus y cube upon x square plus y square. If you go along x axis, along y axis, both will produce same answer, 0, 0, right?
Yeah.
If you put anything instead of y, again all will be same, the value will be same. So try to convert. So we have to show that the value of the function exists at this point, right? So we'll convert the numerator and denominator into same degree, right? And for that we have to use
factorize. We get
yeah.
How would you factorize denominator?
Before using that,
how would you factorize denominator? There is no
such thing.
But we can certainly observe that the denominator is nothing but the form of circle. It will give you the r square. So you can convert it into parametric form, and the parametric form may be in terms of theta also, right? That also we have observed. Like x is equal to r cos theta, x is equal to r cos theta, and y is equal to r sin theta. Right? From the unit circle also we have observed this thing. X coordinate is always in terms of cos, y coordinate is always in terms of sin. So now once you substitute this, it means r square is equal to x square plus y square. Now if you substitute everything in the given function, change the variable, if x tends to 0, y tends to 0, where r will tends to?
Zero.
Are you sure? 0, r tends to 0.
If x and y tend to 0, r will tend to 0.
Oh wait, shouldn't the theta be this thing? Like r is the constant and like theta is the variable.
Theta, is it? We are taking theta as some parameter to represent this x and y. Okay, theta theta is certain parameter here. R is also parameter. So we are converting, you know, we get the relation between R, X and Y here. Because sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So we are getting this relation in terms of R, X and Y. So that's why we have to check for R. When X, Y tends to 0, 0, where R will tends to, Manu was saying, R will tends to 0. So is it just 0 or something else?
I mean if R is 0, both will...
No, but because cos square is the...
This is the hint actually. R will always be positive. Are you getting that? R will always be positive. So R tends to 0 plus. If you are saying R tends to, if you are saying R tends to 0, just R tends to 0, it may approach 0 from negative side. And that doesn't, that is not the case here. Am I clear?
Yeah.
Okay. Manav, understood this?
Yeah.
Okay. So when we... So when we substitute the variable in the given function, limit r tends to 0 plus r cube cos cube theta y square, it should be r cube sine cube theta r square. What would be the value of limit? Is it defined or not defined?
Should be 0 only, no?
Yes, so finite value, right? Because we are getting the finite value of limit, so limit exists and the function is continuous at the given point. So r square will cancel out, so r cos cube theta plus r sine theta, limit r tends to 0, r common, cos cube theta plus sine cube theta, and when you put the values, that would be 0.
Yeah.
Because cos cube theta and sine cube theta defined for all real values, isn't it? Defined for all real values. So that's not the problem. That is not the problem. Even the variable is r here. Okay. Now, last question on this.
But sir, suppose sir, theta was 90.
Yes.
So cos cube 90 would be infinity,
zero.
Right?
0, 0, 0. Tan 90 is infinity. Cos 90 is simplicity.
Sorry, I got mixed up with tan.
So, now next question is limit x comma y tends to 0 comma 0, x square plus y square, ln x square plus y square. So whenever you see x square y plus y square, you always understand that is some parametric equation in terms of r. is it defined?
I'm stuck on, I'm getting like, but I'm getting like ln r square, right? ln of r square, but then r is tending to 0, which
r
is like
0 plus,
which is like negative infinity, right?
Yes. Do you know the graph of ln? If you tends to 0,
yes,
the graph will go negative infinity. Right?
Yeah.
This is the graph of 1. And as you go, like x tends to 0, y tends to minus infinity.
Graph.
So what form you are getting? Minus infinity into
minus infinity into 0.
So that is also indeterminate form. That is also
indeterminate.
Or you can write that as,
yeah.
Are you with us, Manav?
Yeah.
Okay. So, X.
The first step in these things.
First step is to change everything
you can,
to R
square, right? Yeah.
As X,
R square. So we get R square, ln R square.
Yeah. X, Y tends to 0, 0. So, this implies R tends to 0 plus, right?
Oh, so can we do one thing? Can we use L'Hopital that rule by making it ln r upon 1 by r square?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
So this implies limit r tends to 0 plus ln r square upon 1 over r square. Okay, now apply L'Hopital.
Zero.
The
limit
zero
is equal to 0.
Yes, finite value. So, did you get this, Manav?
Yeah.
Did you get limit as 0?
Yeah.
So, limit, derivative of ln r square is 1 over r square into 2 r upon minus 1 over r cube, minus 2 over r cube, right? The derivative of 1 over r square is minus 2 over r cube.
Yeah.
And when we cancel these terms, cancel out r, we cancel out, so we are left with limit r tends to 0 1 over r upon minus 1 over
minus
r,
1 over r,
yeah, so that is limit r tends to 0 r cube upon r minus, okay, like this, and that is equal to limit r tends to 0 minus r square, so the value is 0. Is it clear? So we have to use
L'Hopital.
Okay, so we can make note of some things which are really important. So we have observed one thing: if you are able to find the finite value of the limit, the function is continuous or the surface is continuous at that point. So make note of all of this. So what the continuity is. So, a function is continuous. A function is continuous at any point on the region for which it is defined. Or the domain, the function is defined for the domain. So the function is continuous at any point in the domain. Okay, so the first point in under this is polynomial function. What about the polynomial function? What do you observe for polynomial function? Is it continuous or discontinuous? Or not sure?
Continuous.
So polynomial function is continuous everywhere at all points, you can say. At all points, right? So points will be ordered there always. Understand the difference. We are dealing with the two independent variable. So the points will always be in terms of order there. Okay. So polynomial function is continuous at all points. Now, what about the rational function?
Can be either, can be continuous or discontinuous.
So if suppose I have to make a statement that the rational function is continuous, what is the restriction? Rational function is continuous at all points except what? Except denominator shouldn't be zero. Right, the rational function is p of x comma y upon q of x comma y, isn't it? This is the rational function. So that would be continuous until denominator is zero. Is it clear?
What about something with an oblique asymptote?
Oblique asymptote.
Even that would be discontinuous, right?
That would be discontinuous.
No.
What oblique asymptote?
Oblique asymptote.
Oblique asymptote is the, obviously it is asymptote means the points on oblique asymptote will be, will not give you the finite value of the limit. Are you getting that? Why we are talking about the points on the asymptote? We know that it is asymptote. It means the point on the asymptote will not satisfy the given function. Means the function will be discontinuous at that point. It's simple, no? See, what is asymptote?
Yeah,
asymptote.
Yeah.
It does not lie on the function. It goes parallel to the function.
Mm. Yeah.
So we are talking about the points on the surface. Okay, third point. Continuity holds for composition. Okay, so hold for composition means if suppose function is continuous, if suppose y is equal to sine theta, we know that y is equal to sine x is continuous, right, on its domain. So y is equal to minus sine x is also continuous. Are you getting that? That is the meaning of composition. Y is equal to minus sine x or y is equal to mod sine x, everything of such type will be continuous. Okay, which is derived from the given function, you can say. So the main original function is continuous. Obviously, it's, what should I call, child function will also be continuous.
All the related functions will be continuous.
Yeah. Comparative function, a lot of terms, but need to understand the concept. Okay. Now let's move to the examples. So example is f of x comma y is equal to x cube plus xy plus y cube upon x square plus y square. Is it continuous function or not? Mano will answer this question. Is it continuous function? Or if it is continuous, so let me know where it is continuous. What type of function is this? Mano, you are freeze, I think.
It is a yeah.
Okay. Did you freeze? You know, now
lag. There's a little lag.
Yeah. No. You were not freeze actually. I remember one joke. Nowadays every class is going online, no? So if suppose student doesn't know the answer, so so teacher will
you can actually easily fake like being frozen or the lips or something.
So I thought
you change the rate. You can suddenly start talking fast and then pause, and then it actually seems like you're genuinely.
So, meanwhile, suppose one person going behind, then what will happen?
Then you're in trouble.
You'll be caught. I thought the Mano, frozen for some time. So I remember that. Okay. So let me know what kind of function is this and where the function is continuous. Okay. Let me know the answer. Is it continuous or not continuous? I'm not getting answer from anyone. Dev, you can also answer.
So like from the rules you gave us,
yeah,
according to that second rule, like for a rational function, if the denominator is not equal to
So x square plus y square not equal to zero. Apart from that, actually continuous everywhere, right? According to the rule.
Yes. So that's the answer.
Yeah.
What's the big deal?
So it is continuous.
Yeah.
I was trying to check the limit of x comma y approaching like the order say 0, 0.
But it won't, right? There won't be a circle.
It won't give you the finite value.
Yeah.
So we can see both are polynomial function. This is continuous everywhere. This is also continuous everywhere. But considering them together, the denominator shouldn't be zero. Okay. So it is continuous at all points. At all points, except what? Where the order pair this tends to zero. Okay.
Zero comma zero.
So you can write that as continuous, like this as per the definition, x comma y, where x comma y is not equal to 0, 0. So the function is continuous at this. Okay. Now if you check for 0, 0, as what they were saying, if you check for 0, 0, it won't be continuous. You won't get the answer. You'll certainly get one path where that leads to different height. Are you getting? We have been checking that, no? Along x equal to 0, along y equal to 0, along any curve. Okay. Now let's move to next example. The example is f of x comma y is equal to root x e raised to x by y.
So, x comma y is such that x is greater than equal to 0 and y is not equal to 0.
Yeah.
Very good. So the function is continuous on, so you can write like this, x comma y or dot pair, where x is greater or equal to 0 and y is not equal to 0. Okay. Now next is f of x comma y comma z is equal to x y z upon x.
I can't see anything on the notebook.
Okay.
I don't know.
Is it not visible, right? Yeah. Just a second. I think the network is disconnected for the pad. I think. Just a second. Yeah, is it visible? So x comma y comma not visible. Are you sure?
It's not there only. Your screen is not shared, sir.
Screen share is optional. Yeah.
No, can you refresh from your side? Refresh your browser. Because refresh your browser.
Yeah.
Okay. So x, this is the next example in three independent random variable. Now let me know the continuity of this function. So obviously very easy.
Yeah.
Continuous on all ordered triplet.
X square plus y square plus z square should not be equal to 4.
Yes, should not be equal to 4. Okay, and now if suppose we know the composite function, how to find out composite function? You know this type of function, right? H of x comma y is equal to g of f of x comma y, right? We know such type of terms, h of x comma y is equal to g of f of x. So what we basically do, we basically put this function inside j, isn't it, to find out h of x comma y. So this is called composite function. Now if suppose I give you another example of let's say f of x comma y is equal to x square plus xy plus y square and g of t is equal to t cos t plus sin t. Okay, so what would be the continuity for h of x comma y, which is defined as g of f of x comma y, like this. So what we'll do for this, we first of all find out h of x comma y. Right? Are we going to find that? Are you really want to put this value there? F of x comma y.
No, there has to be a shorter.
You have to see the domain and range.
We simply find the continuity of both the function, and based on that analysis, we can say the resultant function is continuous. Yeah. At what point, right? So if suppose if I talk about f, so f is continuous where? F is continuous
For all values. All real values.
Yeah. F is continuous for all real values. For all values. Okay, we are definitely talking about real. So for all values. Okay. What about this? G of t. Is it continuous? Or is there any restriction for this?
No restriction.
No restriction. So this G is also continuous. G is also continuous at all values. Okay. So what can you say for h of x comma y? If you imagine what all type of function you are. Yeah. There is no restriction, so obviously
continuous only.
Continuous. Yeah.
There is no opposition. Yeah.
So h of x comma y is also continuous for all ordered pair, for all x comma y. Okay. Now similarly, you can find out for this. If suppose f of x comma y is equal to x minus 2y plus 3, and g of x is equal to root t plus 1 by t. First you figure it out, then I'll ask you who will answer this.
Same, right? G of f of x, we have to find it. G of f.
Same function. This is same.
So it has to be basically, it has to be greater than zero.
X has to be greater than 2y minus 3.
Greater than 2y minus
3.
X has to be greater than 2y minus
3. Are you agree with Dev?
Because the whole thing has to be greater than. That's what I said, right? The whole thing, part will be greater than zero.
Yeah, right. So see, this function is basically continuous everywhere. Right, the first function f, and g is continuous for t greater than or equal to zero. Greater than or equal to what would be there?
Greater than zero.
So we are going to substitute.
Just greater than.
Yeah. We are going to substitute t is equal to x minus 2y plus 3, and we know that t is greater than zero, so x minus 2y plus 3 greater than zero, so x minus 2y must be greater than minus 3. So the function is continuous, h of x comma y is continuous, okay, on x comma y such that x minus 2y greater than minus 3. Right. Now next question, this is really important one. Example f of x comma y is equal to x tan y, and g of t is equal to cos t. Thank you. GT is continuous everywhere. What about F?
So, you can, you have to restrict y. You have to restrict y from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 non-inclusive, no?
Minus pi by 2.
No. Okay. It should be y is not equal to n pi by 2 when n is a
odd number. Odd number, yeah. So you can represent that in decent way. You can represent that what you are saying in decent way. Like the function is continuous on x comma y such that y is not equal to pi by 2 or of any other such combination. So plus k pi you can say, where k is integer obviously, so you can take either minus or plus, whatever. We know the period of tan is pi. Are you getting that? From that idea I just wrote plus k pi. So the resultant function h of x comma y is continuous on all ordered pair x y such that y is not equal to pi by 2 plus k pi. Okay, and that resultant function is nothing but g of f of x comma y. So that way you can conclude. Now have you heard the squeeze theorem? We can show the continuity based on squeeze theorem also, sandwich theorem or the squeeze theorem.
Yes,
Manav definitely know that because we have already discussed that maybe, and I know Dev is also knowing. Do you know that, Dev? Yeah. Do you know squeeze theorem?
I know that, yeah.
What is squeeze theorem?
I think when g of x is less than equal to f of x and f x is less than equal to h x, then if both the x approach a certain their limit, I think approaching a certain value, then even the middle one also approaches that.
Okay. So what you said, I'm just drawing that. Okay.
So it'll be like, yeah, two.
This is f of x, this is g of x. Okay. I'm talking this with respect to one independent variable. Yeah. We can understand another in two dependent variables. Okay. So if suppose any function is in between this, okay, this is h of x. So as x tends to, you know, as x tends to a from both side, right, as x tends to a from both side, you can see that f of x and g of x tends to certain value, certain height, right, certain height, okay, a certain value. So obviously if the function h of x lies between f of x and g of x, f of x and g of x, so we know that limit x tends to certain constant of g of x, limit x tends to a h of x, limit x tends to a f of x, and if suppose these two values approach certain constant or finite value, let's say L, so obviously the function which is sandwiched between these two function will have the same limit, and obviously the function is continuous at the point. So this is basically the sandwich or squeeze theorem. I love this name, sandwich. Because now I'm very hungry. So, really. While teaching, I can't eat, but while study or learning, I can eat.
Yeah.
Okay. So, this is the squeeze theorem. So, based on this squeeze theorem, we'll solve one question. Have you written this down?
Once.
Yeah. You perhaps this will be there with you, Manu, I think, because the same explanation I gave you.
Yeah, it is there. Yeah. I have done.
Okay, done. Good. Just a second. The next question on this example is limit x comma y tends to 0, 0, 5x² y upon x² + y². Okay, this is the example. How would you understand by using squeeze theorem? How would you find the limit or whether it is continuous at that point or not? So that we have to find out, right? So I give you explanation for this. Let's understand this. Okay. So 5. We know that 5 is equal to 5, right? We know that. It's a silly question. If I write 5x² upon x², right? That's also holds equal. 5x² upon x² is equal to 5. I'm trying to approach this function. Are you getting that? I'm trying to approach this function, a given function. So now if I add, you know, something, some positive value here in the denominator, some positive value in the denominator, what will happen? If I add some positive, see y² is positive. Are you getting that? y² is always greater than equal to
zero. Value smaller.
Smaller.
Yeah. If you add a positive number, the value will decrease.
Yeah.
Right. So this is this. I'm trying to find the inequality because I'm going to apply the squeeze theorem. Right, and see, this value is also greater than zero. Am I right? This value is, we'll do that later first. So this is the inequality, right? Now what I need y. Okay, I need y in the expression. Are you getting that? See, what I had 5 = 5, then what I am trying to find the function. Why I have taken 5? Because there's 5 in the expression. I'm trying to find the expression in terms of inequality, which is like the function is defined within two functions that I'm trying to find out. Okay. So if we have 5x² upon x², that is equal to 5, obviously. And then I'll add y² in the denominator. That's create inequality in the expression, in the equation here. And that is 5x² upon x² plus y² is less than equal to 5. Now I have to introduce y in the expression. Now I'm not sure whether y is positive or negative. Are we sure? Y is positive or negative? If we multiply both sides by negative number, what will happen? If I multiply both sides,
it switches.
The sign switches. The inequality sign switches. So if I multiply by positive number, then what will happen?
Nothing will happen.
It's the same.
Sign will remain same. Okay. So better to multiply by positive number, but how would I get that? How I make y as a positive? How would I make y as a positive number? By putting y inside modulus.
Maybe.
Yeah, definitely. We'll put y inside modulus. So 5x² mod y upon x² plus y² less than or equal to 5 mod y. See, all are positive basically, isn't it? All are positive here. So this is this, except y. I consider y as positive now. It's putting it inside modulus function. So this is always greater or equal to zero. That function, which is the composition of the given function, that's not the direct function actually, that's part of the function. Are you getting it? That is the child function, you can say, or what Mano said at that time, that's the derived function. What did you say, Mano? That's other form of the function. Okay, so
related function.
So if I apply limit everywhere, limit x comma y tends to 0 comma 0 0 0, limit x comma y tends to 0 comma 0 f x square y upon x square plus y square less than equal to limit x comma y tends to 0 comma 0 5 mod y. Okay, if we have this, what are the values of the limit? At least we can say the limit of 0, that is 0. The value of limit of, you know, the third function is also 0, isn't it? If x, y tends to 0, 0, y mod y also tends to what? 0. Are you getting that? The limit is defined there.
Yeah.
So the limit of this function is sandwiched between these two values, right? These two values, they are equal, 0, 0. So obviously, limit x comma y tends to 0 comma 0, 5 x square y upon x square plus y square is equal to 0, right? And this is the composition of the given function. So the third point in the given rule was the continuity holds for composition, right? The continuity holds for composition. Continuity holds for composition, right? So therefore, limit x comma y tends to 0, 0. See, this is modulus function and actual function was without modulus. So we'll write that one, and that holds continuity at the given point. So therefore, the limit is 0. Is it clear?
Yeah.
Are you sure? Mano?
Yeah.
What about you?
Yeah.
Okay. So the next topic is really interesting. As I promise, if I get some time, I'll start that topic. The next topic is something called as differential.
What is it called, sir? Differential. I didn't hear you.
Yeah, I'm writing. Differentials. Okay. So I hope you know the basic idea of derivative. The derivative function was derived in terms of one independent variable. When the function was 2D, when the function was 2D, how the derivative function was derived. Okay, what is derivative? If I ask you simply, what is derivative? What is derivative? What is first principle of derivative? Do you know that basic idea?
Yeah, like for a small increase in the value, like what does it approach?
X. For a small increment in x.
I know that. Yeah. the relationship between the principal and the limit, like limit of f of x.
Yeah. So basically, we get f of x plus h minus f of x upon h, where h is approaching zero.
Which means, very small, but what is differential? But
that's the first principle.
I'll investigate that thing in slightly different way. Okay, as I used to explain that in IB, or some 10th grade student who has taken the optional mathematics. So I used to explain them differently, but here I have to approach differently. Okay, so what's differential? Basically, the differential means what's really difference between dx del x dy del y. Okay, that's the the idea behind differentials, and by investigating that thing, we'll come over to the three-dimensional figure. Okay. And how it behave over there.
We had done a little bit of this in our demo class.
There we done partial derivative basically. Directly I jump into partial. Okay. I can't explain you the derivative function. Are you getting that? See, for first variable, for one independent variable, the limit, the derivative function is basically limit h tends to zero f of x plus h minus f of x upon h. I know you know this thing. I know you know this very well. But how del x, dx, del y, dy behave, why they are they equal or not equal, and how the things goes with 3D, how the things goes with 3D. So that we have to check it out. Okay, run, rise, everything. So that we'll be discussing next class. Start with there, and then we'll come over to the partial derivative. So in demo class, I have taught you the,
I had one question about the previous thing we solved right there.
Yeah.
So for that, sir, for that function, the only like limitation on it being continuous was x square plus y square should not equal zero, right?
Yes.
But since we proved that it exists when x and y are zero, we proved like the whole thing is continuous, right?
Yes.
Can you say that?
Yeah. The whole surface.
Because
see, the surface is continuous at the point. The surface is. I'm not saying whole. I don't know about whole thing, but the surface is continuous at that point. Means the height of the surface. Height of the object or height of the surface is same if you approach that point from anywhere.
But so the forget that point only. I'm saying for the whole thing, the only limitation would have been x square plus y square not equal zero. Otherwise, it's like according to our rules, right? Of the continuous thing. It should always be continuous for any other value, right?
Yeah. So, see, basically,
according to rule number.
We are getting the finite value of this limit. We are getting the finite value of this limit.
Yeah.
Right. At the given point.
Yeah.
It means the function is continuous. That what we are observing here. Okay.
Right.
So try to imagine something. Then in next class, I'll try to. I think if you have any doubt with respect to this, I'll try to explain everything. Okay, but the thing is, it's very simple. If limit exists, if the value of the limit is finite, the surface is continuous at that point. It's very simple. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Bye bye.
Yeah. Okay, sir. Thank you. Yeah.
Okay, sir. Yeah. Thank you.
So we are meeting a day after, right?
Yeah.
On Friday.
Okay.
Yeah. Bye bye.
Okay. Thank you so much.